Hey everyone, it's Cheryl from Teaching 2 and 3 Year Olds. I thought I would do a quick video on how I handle transitions because I have noticed in my Facebook group this question has been coming up a lot. And it's the start of the year, or kind of the start, depending on when you started, but it's close to the beginning of the school year. And a lot of you have realized, guess what? Transitions with 2 and young 3 Year Olds. Can really be difficult. And I know this because in my 2 decades of teaching, I have had to deal with a lot. In fact, there were times when I'm like, can we just never do transitions? Can we just stay and play the whole morning just like this? But transitions have to happen. And I can tell you that there are a lot of ways that you can make transitions easier. But I wanted to share my biggest tip for transitions, and that is having a spot for them to go to every time you make a transition and having something for them to do. So actually, this was not my idea. When I first started teaching, it was my co-teacher who had the idea to put a basket of books in the middle of the circle time area so that whenever we needed to transition, they would go there and they would know to get a book. I am so thankful that she thought of that because it has saved me with transitions. Before I get into this though, I want to first make sure that you know that you need to look at your schedule and you need to look at the number of transitions you have. That's important because depending on your students and how hard transitions can be, the more transitions that you have, of course, the harder it can be. So that's the first thing you want to look at is how many transitions are happening during your day. Then you want your plan in place. So my plan is, I have my basket of books that are always at my circle time area. And the children know that when I sing a little tune that I think I made up, I don't think I got this from anybody else, they know it's time to come to the circle and get a book.
Time to come and get a book, get a book, get a book. It's time to come and get a book. Come sit down.
And they know that they are to stop what they're doing and come and get a book. And I do this from the very first day because I want this to be so repetitive that they just know what to do. So on the first day, they really might just get their book and barely look at it. I'm not making them sit there that long because I'm just getting them used to the routine of it. Then they can stay there a little bit longer as the year progresses. The point is, when you're asking children to move from one activity to another, it can be really confusing. They might not know, okay, what do we do next? I don't know, where are we supposed to be? So we do this when we are finished with center's time and we're getting ready for circle time. They come and look at their book, and then when I'm ready for us to move to our actual circle time, I sing that same song, I just tell them to put their books away.
It's time to put your books away, books away, books away. It's time to put your books away.
And so we have to teach them, and some years this is harder than other years, to gently put their book in the basket. And I use hardcover books, hard books, board books for this. They fit nicely in my basket. And they are more durable. And then I go, once they put their books away, I remove the basket and we start circle time. Then we do this before we go to the gym. So whatever we're doing when it's gym time, I sing that song again. I have my basket of books in the middle of my circle time area. They come and look at a book. Then I have them put their book away. And then we move to the gym. When we go outside, same thing. I sing that song. The children come to the circle time area. They get a book. They look at their book. Just a short, it doesn't have to be very long. They put their book away and we move on. Snack, same thing. You get the idea. I sing the song, they come to the circle, they look at a book, they put the book away, we move on to snack. So it really is a helpful tip for any kind of transition you have, and it just kind of lets them know, okay, we're not doing that activity more. We're going to be moving on to something else. It has saved, like I said, it has saved me. So I wanted to share that with you in case you are having a hard time with transitions, which I know there are a lot of you out there that probably are, because again, it is such a common, it's a common area of concern with teachers, because again, often when they tell the children, okay, we're gonna go do this, you'll either have children who don't wanna stop what they're doing, they don't know where they're supposed to be, they run off to do something else, but they need to have a place to be. And this way they're not just sitting and waiting for you. You're giving them something to do. Well, example, if we're getting ready to go to snack, I might be putting the last whatever out, their water bottles out or something. I can finish doing that. And by week three, they already know, go get your book and I'm finishing up. They know where to be. Another little tip I have is there will be days, even when you're doing your transitions, where you just know they might not be ready yet to move on to the next activity. They might have an extra burst of energy. Imagine that with two and young three-year-olds. And you know that even with the transition with the books, we might not be ready quite yet. We got to get our wiggles out. That's where I love music. And that's where I have my playlist, my Spotify playlist, which I have on my phone. It's an app. I'm not affiliated with them at all. I just like to share it. I've made all of my playlists public, but I'll look at my playlist. I'll select a song and I'll just get them up and dancing. So sometimes I'll do that during a transition as well. If I feel like, you know, I just sense they might have a little bit too much energy for us to move on to the next activity quite yet. And so music saves me every time when I just have to reset the mood. I hope that you find this tip helpful. I also have a blog post. I'll put the link in this video's description where I give some other ideas as well. So make sure to check that out. I hope that this helps. I will share more with you soon. Thanks for watching.